Honestly, this is complete shit. Do not buy this battery. Hello, today I'm going to disassemble a compatible battery for Makita. You can buy compatible batteries for about half the price of genuine batteries, so you can't help but want one. But before buying a compatible battery, you should make sure if it's really safe to use. According to the National Institute of Technology and Evaluation, there have been reports of fire caused by non-genuine batteries or compatible batteries of power tools. The batteries caught fire while charging. On Twitter, I found a video where smoke coming out of a compatible battery being charged. On a Japanese flea market app, Merukali, compatible batteries for power tools are prohibited from listing due to safety problems. Even brand new products are prohibited. I also watched some videos of compatible batteries on YouTube. Among them, there was a video of a guy whose warehouse burned down because of a compatible battery. However, all the other videos of compatible batteries were about battery capacity, and no one was talking about safety. This is a bit strange because battery capacity should be discussed only after making sure the battery is safe to use. So today I won't talk about battery capacities of compatible batteries. Instead, I'm going to disassemble compatible batteries and make sure they are designed with safety in mind. Here, I prepared a genuine Makita battery, and these are two compatible batteries for Makita power tools. Today I'm going to disassemble both genuine and compatible batteries to make sure they are designed with safety in mind. I'm going to disassemble the genuine battery first because when you disassemble the compatible batteries, you can't tell the difference from the genuine battery if you haven't disassembled it. So I'll evaluate the compatible ones after disassembling the genuine one. Now I'm going to disassemble the genuine one. This is the Makita genuine battery sold at Makita branches overseas. The backside is written in English. You can't open the lid with a normal driver. You need to use this special driver. The screw holes of the genuine battery are filled, so it's not disassembled easily. I removed the lid. I already disassembled this once for filming, so it is not in its original condition. I detached these soldered parts. I removed the cover. You can see the battery cells from the back. The battery cells are covered with plastic. They are protected from impacts to some extent. On the battery cells, there's a circuit board that controls the battery cells. There are IC chips on the control board. The board is covered with transparent resin. It's because power tools are often used in environments where a lot of dust is in the air. Dust might get into the battery, get on top of the control board, and cause tracking. To prevent such incidents, the circuit is covered with resin. Metal plates are spot welded to the battery cells to connect the battery cells together. The metal plates are connected to the control board through thin metal parts. They are connected at here and here. On the other side of the battery, in the same way, the metal plates are connected to the control board at this part and this part. From this part, the batteries are connected to the control ICs. The control ICs constantly monitor the battery voltage and activate protection when overvoltage occurs. Let's see if the through holes and the control ICs are properly connected with wires. The board was painted white, which made it hard to see the wires, so I removed the paint. By shining a light on the backside after removing the paint, you can see if the wire is properly connected. This is a photo of the board when I shined a light on the backside of the board. Look at the two arrows. You can see that the wires are connected to both through holes. These wires are used to monitor the voltage. Let's look at the other side of the board. Here as well, you can see wires at the arrows. I have confirmed that the voltage of all cells is monitored. This is the genuine battery configuration. Five sets of two parallel batteries are connected in series. Four wires are connected to monitor the voltage of each battery. I'll draw the wires. Using the IC chips on the control board, the voltage of all batteries is monitored individually in some way. The voltage of each battery is monitored. It means if any of the cells experiences an overvoltage, protection will be activated immediately. Therefore, no further overvoltage occurs. Look at this orange part here. This part is inserted between the battery cells to detect the temperature. It means the genuine battery can detect overheating. Next, let's disassemble compatible batteries. I got two compatible batteries. One is a general compatible battery that is sold on Amazon for around $30. It has received decent reviews. Considering genuine batteries are sold for around $90, $30 is a very cheap price. Here is the other compatible battery. On the internet, it is considered to have relatively high quality. Compared to regular compatible batteries, this compatible battery is sold for about twice the price. I'm going to disassemble this one as well. Both of the compatible batteries have round PSE marks on them. These PSE marks don't ensure high-level safety because round PSE mark can be obtained by self-declaration. In other words, you don't need to pass a third-party assessment to get this type of PSE mark. Of course, if you want to, you can conduct a third-party assessment on these compatible batteries. But you can't tell whether these batteries have passed such third-party assessment or not. Let's disassemble this cheaper compatible battery first. The screw holes are not filled, unlike the genuine battery. Done. A control board is on the battery cells. The control board looks quite small, so I guess the ability of the board is pretty much limited. The surface of the board is not covered with gel. An IC chip is on the backside, but the backside is not covered either. If any dust sticks to the board, it might malfunction. The wire connected to the board is spot welded here. It carries a large current. This one's also spot welded. Under this masking tape, there is a thermal fuse. It operates at 70 degrees Celsius. Let's take the battery cells out of the case. There's no cover on the battery cells. If the battery drops on the floor, the impact from the case is directly transmitted to the battery cells. There's a possibility that the plastic parts of the cells break or tear because of that. I disassembled a bit more. There is another temperature sensor on the other side of the board. As for the monitoring of the battery voltage, I found that the battery voltage of each cell is not monitored individually. See this thin wire connected to the board. It's soldered to the spot welded tab on the battery cells. These two cells are connected in parallel. The wire is used to monitor the voltage of these cells. The other cells are not monitored individually. Only other voltage that is monitored is the voltage of all the cells combined. The only cells that are individually monitored are these two, whose voltage is 3.8 volts. The other monitored voltage is 18 volts, all the cells combined. Therefore, the voltage of the remaining four series of batteries is not monitored individually. Only combined voltage is monitored. This battery cannot cope with an overvoltage in one of the four series of cells because they are not monitored individually. Honestly, this is complete shit. Do not buy this battery. The battery configuration is the same as the genuine battery. Five sets of two parallel batteries are connected in series. However, the way it monitors the voltage is problematic. There is only one wire to monitor the voltage. Therefore, the voltage of this cell is monitored individually, but for the other cells, only combined voltage is monitored. With this configuration, if an overvoltage occurs in this battery cell, protection can be activated. However, if overvoltage occurs in other cells, protection may not be able to be activated because the battery monitors only the combined voltage of the four cells. Let's say the voltage of this cell rises a little. And let's say the voltage of this cell decreases a little. The increase and decrease in voltages of these cells cancel each other out, so the total voltage looks normal. As long as the characteristics of the battery cells are consistent, such case does not occur. However, when the battery is used for a long time, it deteriorates and the characteristics of each cell become more variable. This compatible battery cannot cover such cases. Next, let's disassemble this compatible battery. According to online reviews, it has relatively high quality. The screw holes are not covered. The circuit board of this compatible battery looks similar to the genuine one. The spot welded tabs are connected to the circuit board with thin metal parts. The other side is the same. This part and this part are connected. It looks like the voltage of each battery cell is monitored individually. I'll look into it later. There are various components on the board. The genuine battery was covered with resin, but this compatible battery is not. It's probably for cost cutting. Therefore, if debris like metal pieces get into the board through these gaps and stick to the board, the battery may malfunction. Let's take the battery cells out of the case. The cells are covered with a case just like the genuine battery. It's covered by two layers of cases, the outer case and this inner case. Therefore, it seems to have the same level of shock resistance as the genuine battery. I removed the circuit board to have a closer look. The soldering quality is not very good. Particularly, this part is the worst. It seems this board doesn't monitor the battery temperature. There are through holes to attach a temperature sensor here, but nothing was attached using the holes. On the battery cells, this is where a temperature sensor should be inserted, but the hole was filled with plastic. Now I'm going to look into the battery voltage monitoring. You can connect battery cells to these four through holes. Let's look at the back side of the board. As for the cell connected to this hole, overvoltage can be detected because you can see a wire connected to this hole. As for the other three holes, you can't see wires connected to them. To be sure, I'll shine light on the backside as I did with the genuine battery. Now I'm shining a light on the board from the backside. At first glance, I thought the batteries were connected to all of the four holes and some kind of battery voltage protection measures were implemented on all cells. However, when you actually shine a light on the backside and look closely, the one on the top right is the only through hole connected to the battery cells. The other three holes are not connected to anything. It appears the three holes are only used to hold the spot welded tabs of the batteries. Let's have a look at the backside. Only the through hole on the top left is connected to the voltage monitor. The other three parts are not connected to the monitor. It means these three through holes are just pretending to monitor the battery voltage. I can't say why they made these holes for sure, but it's likely that they wanted to make it look like the genuine battery by making these holes. Well, I can't say for sure without asking the person who designed this. Today I disassembled a genuine Makita battery and two compatible batteries. Both of the compatible batteries achieved lower prices than the genuine battery at the expense of safety. That was what I found out. People say safety comes first. Safety must be your number one priority. If the compatible batteries secured safety at the same level as the genuine battery and achieved lower prices at the same time, it's totally fine. You must sacrifice something to lower the price, but safety can't be sacrificed. Power tools are often used at construction sites. At a decent construction workplace, it's prohibited to bring in compatible batteries for power tools. It's because, as we've seen so far, such compatible batteries are not well protected and may catch fire while charging or while being used. When you buy a compatible battery, you may feel like you've saved a few dollars. However, if the battery catches fire, the damage could amount to tens or hundreds of thousands of dollars, or even millions of dollars possibly. Therefore, I do not recommend using compatible batteries. Use genuine batteries at all times. All the batteries I disassembled today are going to be recycled. I'll get rid of the genuine one as well because I disassembled it and it can't be used anymore. If you want to buy the genuine battery, I attached a link to Amazon in the description so you can buy it from there. Of course, you can buy it at a DIY store as well. Thank you for watching.